Welcome once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Toronto, Brampton, Canada. Welcome once again. I say Toronto because that's where many people know. People know Toronto than Brampton. Brampton is a city, but Toronto is known than Brampton. So when you are in Toronto, you are almost in Brampton. Therefore, I mention Toronto because Toronto is nearby Brampton. Thank you very much, and I thank you, and I welcome you. Newcomers, welcome. Welcome, newcomers. First-timers, welcome. Thank you very much for coming. Anti-marriage must die by fire. This demon must die. Demon that is disgracing you, make you miserable, live like that, it must die. It must die by the fire of God in Jesus' name. There are many who wants to get to marry but cannot. These are the people who want to concentrate in this prayer season. It is important to note that the rate of marriage distress calls for caution on the side of singles. Caution because you choose many after your destiny. You choose may affect your destiny and eternity. That's why we need to pray so that when you choose the right partner, it will be for your life. But if you choose a wrong one, then it will affect your destiny for life. That's why you see we have to pray very hard. We have to seek God, that God to bring the right partner. There's some forces, there's some evil prophets who profess to people long prophecy, and then they go for it. At the end, they suffer and they end up divorcing. I know a woman came to me, and a prophet prophesied her about her marriage, and she went ahead and married a man. They didn't live for 3 months. Only 3 months, their marriage was split into pieces. 3 months, the marriage was destroyed. I'm telling you that there's some satanic prophets whom the devil sent to your life to prophesy to you. And then you believe because you believe every prophet. Test the spirit of the prophet. When the prophet has told you something, even me, go and pray, confirm from God. There must be 2 witnesses or 3 witnesses. Don't go with one. Don't go with one false. Don't go with one. 3 always are the witness. 3 is the witness. 2 or 3, you must get the confirmation before you go ahead. I'm telling you, false prophets have deceived so many people, so many marriage. They even come and marry you. After marrying you, the marriage is scattered. Therefore, I pray that you will not be a portion of that. In the name of Jesus, I am standing with you to pray that God will ordain you and bring you the right person. If you are engaging someone who is not yours, if you are engaging someone who cannot live with you forever, let that person get away from your life in Jesus' name. I pray that God, that engagement break up and be destroyed. There is no point you will be going to get this marriage and it is not going to stay. I am praying long time marriage, not a contract. I am not praying for contract marriage. I am praying long time life. Death will separate you according to the Bible. Because God himself is the one who said in the book of Genesis, Genesis 2 verse 8, it is not good for a man to live alone. Therefore, I will make the helper. So you are the helper of a man. Therefore, no one will bring sunder, no division, no divided. Nothing will come to destroy your marriage in the name of Jesus. Marriage is not ruled by animals. Kingdom principle, hoping from a woman to woman or man to man. Thoughts, your marriage will never be better than your spiritual life. Your spiritual life regularly all about your marriage and the choice you make in marriage. The life you live in Christ determined the choice you make in your marriage. Proposals. Marriage has also been one area of problem for many believers. You may be a good Christian today, but during the time of your marriage, countship, how you conduct yourself and the choice you make, and how you make the choice will determine spirituality, a quality countship, bring a quality marriage. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. A quality choice affects the quality of your countship. So many good believers have been carried unto obligation by the ship of courtship and wrong relationship, purpose of marriage. In the Bible, in the book of Genesis 2 verse 18, in the book of Malachi 2 verse 15, go there and read those scriptures. Malachi 2 15 to 16. God, as well as a man, have proposed for marriage. Man in marriage need a companion to love, care, and cherish in good and bad condition. To kill boredom, Adam needed a companion, and this is the will of God and not man. God, Adam needed a companion, so it is not the will of Adam. Adam himself, Adam needed a companion, and this is the will of God, not man. So when God created Adam, he looked at Adam and says, Adam, you need a companion. So it is not your will, but the will of God. It's God who decided to bring a partner. Otherwise, God could say, okay, Adam, stay with the animals, be with them, or stay there, just be yourself. But he decided to bring a female, to be a companion, to be a maid, to be a help. God, through our marriage, hallelujah, God, although our marriages went to raise godly seed to populate the earth, God does not just need children, but godly seeds. God loves godly seeds, and these are his priority. And these are a priority. Godly seeds hardly come out of an ungodly marriage. The chance are 1 in 1,000. When there is an important, God is, let me talk to you properly. God is looking godly seed. He doesn't want ungodly seed. That's why he wants you as a Christian to be in house of God, to get a Christian who can take care of you, body of you. If you go to get non-Christian and you are a Christian, you believe that when you get this Christian, you will pray for that person to get safety, then you can marry. That's a lie. Let the person be saved, be baptized, and go through deliverance, then let God choose for you. If God give you an unbeliever, for sure, who is in the world who does not fear God, then that would be a question. That would be not God. Because God does not work that way. God will give you the desire of your heart. He doesn't give you a wrong desire. We have seen so many people saying that, I got an unbeliever, I will pray for this believer to get saved, and I will marry her or him. The believer can pretend. An unbeliever can pretend that he wants to come to you, and because he wants you, and then after coming to you, you will see the picture of the person. Even the children, they will pair, it will be disaster children, because this person has pretended to be a Christian and yet is not a Christian. He's a witch. That's why you see a lot of witchcraft in the church. They come to priest pastors, they come to priest members that they are Christian, they go to church, but they are not. Therefore, people of God, I pray that God Almighty will open your eyes and your inner eyes and your heart to see the right person you will marry. Remember, they are pretenders who will turn to be serpent and python. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, my Father, I want to thank you. I want to thank you and give you all the glory, my God. In the name of Jesus Christ, the devil hates two godly people staying together because they have reward from such a union. Ecclesiastes 4 verse 9 to 12. The devil feeds on fornication. Glory be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Woman of God, we are on prayer conference and you need to join the prayer conference. Join Periscope. Okay. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. That is my dear sweet sister. Yes, God is good. We thank God that God is able. I don't know if you hear me or you are not hearing me. Can you wave? Can you say amen if you hear me? Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I want to see their hearts. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Just give me more hearts. Yes. The devil feeds on fornication. Fornication and adultery. Where there is a good marriage, the devil is not happy. Because he feeds on those adultery and fornication. He wants people to commit adultery and fornication. That's when he gets is happy. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Where there is a marriage institution, this evil is mammon. Since the devil worked to destroy the life of men and women through immorality, he destroyed marriages to promote sin. In 1 Corinthians 7 verse 2, it is because right it comes into the city through godly family. The devil like deceive people and make them to commit fornication. That is what the devil is very happy, because he feeds from there. He feeds from fornication. When people are doing that, he is very happy. And when fornication and adultery in the family, the marriage will be disaster. That's why cheating comes in, then the fight start coming. Trust, no trust. So you find that it is difficult for the marriage to stay. Therefore, I pray that God Almighty, you will not be like that. The Lord will give you the partner that will love you and you will have him. No fornication, no adultery in your portion. In the name of Jesus, I pray that God, every stronghold holding you, I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Stronghold of anti-marriage spirit must die. In the name of Jesus Christ, strong of anti-marriage spirit, including witchcraft power, they must die in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, this is one of the strongest forces that the enemy uses against marriage. Evil powers in your foundation. Your foundation is a combination of the activities of your ancestors and which of your family is standing. Family idols, spirit wife, spirit husband, that are highly aggressive of your marriage. What a spirit. They are a spirit from the marine world that pollute the life of men and women who expose to their manipulation, familiar spirit, seducing spirit, inherited curses, and evil covenant, spirit of Jezebel, soul tie. Your marriage is targeted on anti-marriage forces. If it shall fall into any of the following category: marriage, sodomized by certain rituals, any marriage where you have to get involved in ritual, such as exchange of blood, it is not marriage. Therefore, I am praying that God will deliver you. God has spoken to you about it. You are not troubled because they are misled by evil prophets. That's what I was talking about, evil prophets. Yes, Lord, thank you. Prophets in the marital choice. When you are marrying from a programmer's home, be careful, because this marriage is highly participated by forces of darkness. Programmers, spirit, they are the people who marry multiple marriage. So when you are involved in that, you have to ask God to deliver the money, and you have to go totally deliverance, because it is a very serious place that you have entered. If it is your first, you are a youth, both of you, first marriage, that is fine. But the moment you come to the person, a divorced person, second marriage, that marriage, fourth marriage, third one, you know there is a demon living there. And this demon must be dealt accordingly. If you don't deal with that demon, your marriage will not stay, because there's power that is falling in that marriage. That's what we call polygamy. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I destroy them. I bind them. You will not be the one. You are not the one. Everything the enemy has been planning against marriage, you are not the one. Your marriage will be holy. Your marriage will succeed. You will enjoy your marriage in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you. Marriage without the divine approval of God, when God is not in the marriage, or when his face is not sought, it is like to desecrated marriage. So you have to involve God. You have to, like when we said these 3 days prayer and fasting, I pray that God will answer you. God will show you through. It is as serious you deny, you refuse to eat because you need the right partner. You need the direction of God to give you the right, because you tried the first, second, third, there is nothing. Or you have been so old, you wanted to be married but nothing. You tried this but nothing is coming. So you are praying that God would bring somebody who will take care of you, and you will take care of the person. Therefore, I pray that God Almighty, Father who does not lie, will bring your partner that nobody knows, in the name of Jesus. He will connect you in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I want to thank you so much. I pray that God Almighty will help you and will set you free from this demon that is holding you. I pray that my God will kill every anti-marriage. Any demon denying you from getting married, I destroy them. Some people, they are married, they have husband, but the demon has already taken the husband. They have taken the marriage. Some people, they don't talk with their husband, with their wife. They live in the one house. One is living in another room, or one is living in another room. Or they can live in one bedroom, but when in the bed, they give each other bath. They don't face together. They don't talk. They don't cook. Some they live in the basement, or some they cook their own food. That's what the enemy do. The enemy make people live miserable life. The enemy has taken your marriage. Therefore, every satanic anti-marriage demon that is involving this family, die. Die in the name of Jesus. I pray you restoration, marriage restoration. Wherever is living in such a life, I destroy that demon. I command the demon, you spirit husband, spirit wife in that bed, die in the name of Jesus. The spirit husband is sleeping on your bed. Now, when you enter there, you are not a woman there. He is the one who is taking in charge. You are there, like a dead body. The desire of your husband is gone. The desire of your wife is gone. The husband cannot even rest. Even if you do what? His desire is gone. He cannot have sex with you whatsoever, because his desire is already gone. I pray that any demon that is attacking this man, let them die in the name of Jesus. Let them die by fire in Jesus' name. When the desire of man is gone, it cannot function. Therefore, I pray every power that is making this man to go this way, let them die in Jesus' name. This is forces of marine spirit that is affecting men and women. They make their marriage. They marry, but they are not living together. They are like single. They are single. They don't meet. A lady was telling me that they live with their husband many years. They don't meet together. They don't have love together. The man is in his own. The man, in fact, he can even bring a girlfriend in the house. And the woman does not care, doesn't care. Even the woman can go and have his stuff outside. And these people, they go to church. They live miserable life. I was listening. I said, God, where are you? What is this, God? Deliver them. Then I prayed for them and I asked them, get oil. Go and spread the oil in your bed and hold your hands on your bed and say, you spirit husband, get out of this bed. And you spirit woman, get out of this bed in Jesus' name. Pray those two spirits, command them to get that bed and go. They started prayer and fasting, because our prayer goes with prayer and fasting. After day one, day two, day three, then the man started loving with the woman. The man said, ah, mama so and so, how are you? It was a miracle to the woman to hear that. They were not talking at all. They never come together. Then that night, it was fantastic for their life. I'm telling you, people are suffering in the house. Therefore, I pray that you will not be the one. That's what you will say. I will not be the one. I will enjoy my husband. I will not be divorced because God hates the divorce. I will never leave my husband. That is my husband. I will not be the one. The powers of darkness, that will claim my husband. It will not claim my husband. I have refused in Jesus' name. I am binding them and expose them in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I just want to thank you right now, and I give you all the glory, Jesus. You are a wonderful God in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, we pray that God will destroy every marriage. All evil counselors against your marital life corrupts and die in the name of Jesus. I pray that, oh God, my Father, I pray every spirit, husband and or wife, lose your hold on this person by fire in the name of Jesus. I command you, spirit husband, spirit wife, lose your hold upon this person now in the name of Jesus. Lose your hold upon this man. Lose your hold upon this woman in the name of Jesus Christ. Every curses against your marriage be broken now in the name of Jesus. I command every curses against your marriage be broken to pieces in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, any payment, sacrifice made against your marriage be revoked by the Most High God. Any altar of Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ, I break them to pieces in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father God, in the name of Jesus, every evil ceremony against your marriage be destroyed in Jesus' name. Evil ceremony against your marriage be destroyed in Jesus' name. Satanic ceremony, satanic ring, satanic gown, satanic wedding, catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to praise your name. In the name of Jesus, I release your spouse. I release your wife. I release your husband by fire, by thunder. Where your wife has been engaged, where your husband has been engaged, be released. I release your husband. I release your wife by fire in Jesus' name. I am speaking the word of God from the mouth of the prophet. Right now, receive your partner. Receive your husband. Receive your wife by fire, by thunder. In the name of Jesus, wherever he is, receive him. Receive them. Receive your wife. Receive your husband. In the name of Jesus. Those who are engaged, those who are having partner, I pray that you will not be the one that will have today, tomorrow, you leave the marriage. You will not the one in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Yes, you will love your husband and your husband will love you and will take and look after you. And you also, you look after your husband in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank God that he is able to deliver you and set you free in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. People of God, remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhmministry.blogspot.ca. Also, you can call us. We have numbers. You can reach us. Our number is 647-608-5207. And we have a free line number, 877-241-341-3420. And the other number, you can reach me direct. You can call 905-487-71966. The number, once again, is 905-487-71966.